Good morning. So, yesterday we were setting up tests for my little Go HTTP API server. And I think I'm going to carry that on this morning. We have a login test, and now I need to start filling out some of the others. Okay. What do we have? Let's just double check that. So over there, I can't remember. Was that a little test of it failing? Yeah, okay, that's fine. Good. Okay. I thought so. Right, we need a little cleanup here. So at the moment, we've got two instances of just setting up the basic service before we then start using it later. So I think it would be a good idea to refactor that into a little local function because we're going to use that over and over again. I think I'm good in keeping these writers being initialized, callers and writers, being initialized inside. And I don't think there's anything else that I desperately want to. Well, I suppose I could do the mock. That could be useful as well. Though it's pretty skimpy there, isn't it? Yeah. Now I'll just do the service setup for the time being. Because what do we get back from it? Service. Got the server, and that's all we actually need there. Okay, so we're just gonna create a server. All right, let's grab that. And we'll just do it high up, I think. Not every test is going to need it, so I don't want it in part of startup or anything. So yeah, we'll just do that. Yeah, maybe. Great API. No, I just got, yeah. Here's the API stuff. It's going to return what? It's going to return a server. Let's see how that goes in a minute. Yeah, I saw that in a sec. So what we probably need there is. I don't want to create type server. What's the actual import for that? None. Oh, it is. That's the wrong place. Don't. That's where I want to be. Just net HTTP. Okay. So long since I did that. So maybe that's the wrong. No, it's auto as well, isn't it? That's why. Hello? Documentation, please. So this is new to me then. So how do I import that server struct? Is that simply just add in package auto HTTP? You can't tell I don't do go yet, can you? Okay. And we already have that. I think it's Google time. Rather, duck, go get time. Because I'm not going to be able to. Maybe. Maybe I'm defining too much. It's an interface. It's using that. I should probably be reading up on this stuff before I try and use it. Okay. What we're going to do here then, I don't actually know. Oh, is it as easy as that? Do I? So, was it HTTP? Oh, it'd help if I spelt it right. I keep putting an extra T in. Okay, that's better. Right, I just had to specify the package, of course. I need more coffee. Way more coffee. I'm a bit earlier this morning. Got lots on today. So, right, where were we? Create API server. So here we want to take the stuff out. Let's do server. Okay. And same here, get rid of that committed out code. Now, in theory, that small refactor there should not cause any problems. So let's give it a quick test. Stuff. Sorted. Commit that off. Okay. Right, so we have test login there. What's next? So after we've logged in, we probably want to test. Should we do the password stuff just yet? Maybe we should just test. They're going to be difficult because there's little emails and things that go off there that I'd like to test. They're not quite straightforward. Don't think I quite. I'm not quite ready for that yet. We'll do that in a minute, the next time. Let's do. Should we do add goals? get goals. Let's do get goals, because that's going to bring back nothing first. It's got no transactions. Oh, good point. I just thought I needed to finish off. I wanted to do a failure case on the test login. I wanted to do a case of passing in invalid credentials and getting back a failure there. So I need to I want to do another function here where it's doing test login failure or something. Lock it up, do the thingy. Do that. Now, I do not expect an insert. Because it's going to fail, so that's good to go. And I do expect that if I pass in a rubbish password, well, there's two different things I want to do. Yeah. So we expect that if we do successfully, we have the right email address, but we have a duff password. We just expect an authentication error. Of invalid password. Do that first, but then I'm going to test to make sure that things don't exist as well. So we expect the query to work, but the password is not matching. Good. And how does is do? Is fail. Yeah, I don't think I want to do a fail. Okay, so I'm going to have to do like a false. I do like how focused this little testing library is. You don't even have like it's false because that just is a negative and true. So you just need to do a false expression. Sorry. False expression, that is true. It's a little bit more work though. Okay, let's think. Now I need to work out what I don't expect. I don't expect member ID or token string. So, is true. Is there such a thing as not contains? It's going to be the same thing, isn't it? Yep. Just need to check that. Okay. Okay, that's fair enough. So actually, I basically want the same thing. I just want to do false equals that, blah, blah, blah. By D. Something or other. In fact, let's take the quote out just in case. And the same goes for token string. Okay. So does it put a dummy one in then? Oh yeah, we already know that from yesterday when I found out that. What was that I noticed? Can't remember what it was, but it was something that I didn't expect. Okay, well, in that case, what we'll do is we will take the previous test there. Yeah, we'll take that value and we'll still test to make sure it's now false. And here, how can I test that that's not got a token string? Do I even need to? I guess that's going to be like a little bit of regex or something, isn't it? Oh, I suppose we could unpack. Could unpack it as JSON and then check the value is empty. Okay, how do I do JSON in Go then? Let's find out. Code in JSON. Decoder. Marshall text, Marshall JSON. So I've taken a slice of bytes. Sticking it in inventory there. And then it's doing some stuff on it, okay. I just don't want that. Okay. That's just taken a bunch of JSON objects. Do I really want to do a struct? I suppose I've got the structs. I think I could do it, but do I really need to at the moment? I just want to get a basic. Do we get errors or not? That might be something I can come back to. If I get to the point where I have to inspect the values. Yeah, I can imagine like if there's dates and things I want to check, I can unpack it, check the dates correct and things like that. If it's calculated. But I don't need to do that right now. That seems like a lot of work just for what I'm trying to do at the moment, which is to get some basic testing surface area. I think I'm going to punt on that for the moment. Don't need to do it. So, what we can do here is just drop that. The time. Eek. Okay. I need to wrap this one up. I think I'll just finish off doing this test failure then, and then move on to the next API next time. Okay, so what else I want to do? I want to make sure that if we pass in a invalid email address that we don't get good data. So, how do we do that? We are going to be basically doing a bunch of that stuff. Reuse this, so okay. So this is actually going to be unneeded. Because we're going to do expect that the query will return an error of some sort. So will return Is that an error? I guess we'll find out in a minute. I need an example of how to use that. What? Okay, so let's see if we do get what kind of error we get on that then. Just takes a string, doesn't it? Let's do. I want to see what actually comes back. Don't know what's going to come back at all, so. And why is that complaining? Oh. That's interesting. Okay. So, in that case, can I just do this? Oh, return error, not found, but we don't actually know what we're going to get yet. And I don't actually know whether I'll get a error or just like an empty record set, because I don't know how this thing works. But I guess we're going to find out. So, I'm going to pass in Google, and the wrong password's fine. Should still get an okay result. We should get a different API response. I know this is putting in tests around the wrong way. Not doing exactly red green here, but I'm just catching up, and then eventually I'm going to start doing red green testing. And we can leave that in as well. Okay, let's see what that does, because I'm not sure what we're going to get back from testing. Right, I remember, not found. That's not giving me a lot. Oh no, this is where I've been doing the fatals at the moment. Yep. Yeah, because that shouldn't really be a fatal error. I shouldn't be actually returning an error there, I think. I think it should just be an empty record set. If I'm getting actual SQL errors, then I want to know about it. That's why we do the fatal there. That gets logged and then the service gets restarted. So, I will be changing that later. I want to make it a little bit more robust so it just logs and, but for the time being, we need to know how to do an empty record set in this testing. Let's see. Is there anything on there? Close ever. Thank you. I wonder if it's just don't add rows. Could it be that simple? Why is that complaining now? Oh. I wonder if that works. It's just going to be an empty record set, row set, whatever you're going to call it. There we go, member SQL. No rows in result set. How do you do an empty record set in this SQL mock? So, it's doing unfair. Okay. they are. They're doing something different there. They're doing a 500 error back. Which doesn't help me. I wonder if anyone's asked about it. Sound good to me. Okay, well, I am kind of lost on that one. If I can't do... What if... Result. I wonder what that means. What an error. Okay. What was that error? No rows in result set. I wonder if I'm actually, if that's a real bug in the API. Let's try. It's a bit sneaky, but we'll try it. It's going to fail though, isn't it? That's the problem if it's doing this. Yeah, I think I'm a bit. It's another go do research thing on this one, but. Yeah. I'm never going to get to the point of checking the expectations because it's failing. What if I don't? What if I, what if? So a quick play with this. Let's quickly do a instead of fatally out. We return the error. So it's going to do a 500. We're just going to return an empty. Empty response and the error. So the API will have to handle it. Let's say front end. And then I'll expect a 500 error on the status. Okay, but for the time being, we'll see what that does. Where is your result set? Just not 200. So that did the right thing then. Just, well, I didn't check the expectations. Next one's going to fail, but I should get past 500. Yep, not true. String contains authentication error. What did it return? Well, it's not even there, is it? Actually, I'll tell you what I could do. Just see what I am getting back. No, it's empty. Two, three. It's not actually empty. Double check that. So when I get an error, I get a body that is the error. Is that right? No. There's an easy way to test this. We will actually deploy it and then see what happens when I try and log in with the invalid. Email Wibble at something.com. Password doesn't matter. That's fine. Okay. Just a plain string. I wonder if that's the problem there. It's got a new line. What's the time? Way later than I expected. Okay. Okay, so now we're going to test to see whether the response actually just contains the error instead of being exactly like it. Ugh. So that works, okay. Right, okay. I wonder if that might be something I can do. That's something I'm going to handle because why? Yeah, because if I revert that, I I'm not sure I've not properly tested, not logging in properly. I think I handle it a different way on the front end at the moment. I think I just catch like the 500 error. It's just a no response, isn't it? 502. Because it's dying. Which is not good. That's not what I really want, really. And I was going to change that. So I am going to have to handle that now. That's something to do then. Maybe. Yeah, it's because I just haven't got rid of this yet. Thank you. Sometimes it's too clever. It catches you before you finish doing your coding. Okay. Good enough, I remember. That's a better way of handling things. Although, ideally, it would be I catch an error. That's not great, actually. I need to finish up, so to do. Do not fail for. What's the error? Okay, that's what I'll have to do tomorrow. I need to upgrade my API. I guess this is why testing is good, because I've now found out that I really can't handle just failing out. I do need to handle any errors appropriately. It's time to make the change. So that's all gonna change as well. Basically, what if what did I do last time? Yeah. That's what I'm expecting. That's what I'm going to expect. I'm expecting it to return good, but with an authentication error. Once I've made this change here, which doesn't work at the moment. So it should still fail. Ah. Yeah. Good. Okay. Right, I need to get on. So that's actually, I guess that's a success in some ways. I'm glad I've done that. I need to now properly handle these errors. I'm putting in this test condition in my test, this failure condition in my test is going to help me round out the way we handle errors. Good stuff. Okay, well, next time I'll carry on with that. Work out how to catch particular types of errors and hopefully deal with them so that this test passes, because at the moment it's a red test and I need to make it green. Okay, good stuff. All right, thanks for watching, and until next time, take care.